by dreams that will never be fulfilled in this life. Southern Illinois, home for the best Christian music and the biggest variety. It is local Christian radio, 105.5 and 90.9 The Vine. Come alive, that is Jeremy Camp. It is 8:27. As we've got sports on the way, then after that we'll check the weather, and then Lora will join us in the studio. More to come. Stay tuned. A lot to talk about with Lora. The Vine Morning Show on a Monday morning, coming up from Real Life Radio.
Real Life Radio is thankful for the financial partnership we have with Greenwald & Sons Construction in Wayne City and in Mount Vernon. They specialize in residential and commercial construction and remodeling. They have a long list of satisfied customers spanning over 38 years. Whether it's a church addition, business expansion, or new home construction, Greenwald & Sons Construction of Wayne City and Mount Vernon are experts that you can depend on. Their phone number is 895-2044, and we thank them for their support of local Christian radio.
Christian music and programming on The Vine is made possible by Wes Rogers Tire and Auto Service in Mount Vernon. Located at 1321 South 10th Street in Mount Vernon, Wes Rogers Tire and Auto Service offers customer service the way it should be and is 100% locally owned and operated. With ASE certified mechanics, Wes Rogers Tire and Auto Service is committed to your complete auto care satisfaction. Their phone number is 315-6497. And we are thankful for their support.
The following is a real-life story from Trinity Debt Management.
I had numerous credit cards, and I was struggling with paying them off, so I made the call.
If you're in debt and you need help, call Trinity at 1-800-606-4260.
The people at Trinity are very friendly. They will do whatever you need them to do in order for you to feel better about being in a very difficult place.
If your debt has you down, call Trinity at 1-800-606-4260.
It is time right now for Hey Howard. And the one-minute feature this morning is being underwritten by Fairfield Banking Company.
Hi, this is Ashley DeVoy with the Fairfield Banking Company. We've been strongly rooted in this area since 1892. Our foundation is strong, and we offer a unique checking account for customers 50 and older. It's called the 1892 Founders Club Checking, and it puts your money to work with interest paid on balances of $1,000 or more. You've worked hard to build a strong financial foundation for yourself, and now it's time to reap the rewards, including free checks and paper statements. Learn more about the 1892 Founders Club Checking account available at the Fairfield Banking Company, 915 Commerce Drive, member FDIC, and equal housing lender.
With practical answers about how to handle money, here's financial teacher Howard Dayton with today's question. Hey Howard, is it okay to ask the Lord to bless us financially, or is that wrong?
It's certainly permissible to pray for the Lord to bless financially. In 3 John verse 2, John writes to a friend, I pray that in all respects you may prosper and be in good health, just as your soul prospers. You know, I'm fully convinced that spiritually the safest way to prosper is to focus on being faithful to earn money and to manage it God's way. And to oversimplify what we're to be faithful to do, we're to work hard, give generously, spend wisely, save consistently, and get out of debt. When we do these things, asking for God's favor on our finances is perfectly okay. Want to learn how you can be faithful to handle money God's way? Visit CompassOne.org.
If your goal as a parent is to raise kids who love God, just remember, your kids will only take their faith as seriously as you take yours. Helping you love God 24/7. 24/7. 90.9 The
And good morning, everyone. Time now to check sports on this Monday morning. High school football action from this past Saturday. Benton Rangers got a win over West Frankfort 29-28. El Dorado a winner over Hamilton County Saturday 40-0. It was Newton 48, Robinson 8. And Tolono Unity, they defeated Red Hill. Tolono Unity 49 and Red Hill 7. Boys cross country Saturday at the Springfield Invitational. Marion placed 3rd, Muscoota 5th, Mount Vernon Rams placed 11th, Highland 13th, Belleville East 15th, East St. Louis 16th, and Cahokia placed 20th. Now the girls cross country at the Springfield Invitational Saturday. Muscoota placed 2nd, Mount Vernon Lady Rams placed 7th, Belleville East placed 11th, and Granite City placed 16th. Boys soccer action from Saturday, Mount Vernon Rams a winner over Harrisburg 8-0. Newton and Salem played to a 0-0 tie. Waterloo Jabot over Metro East Lutheran 8-0. Girls tennis action from Saturday, Mount Vernon Invitational 2 topless was the winner, followed by Marion. Mount Vernon placed 3rd, Heron 4th, and Salem 5th. Girls high school volleyball action from Saturday, the Heron Invitational Pool 1. South Central defeated Cesar Valier Waltonville, and Carterville turned around defeated Cesar Valier Waltonville, and Marissa Coulterville defeated Cesar Valier Waltonville. South Central over Marissa Coulterville. Carterville defeated Marissa Coulterville, and South Central over Carterville. Pool number 2, Heron defeated Mount Vernon. Heron then defeated Gallatin County. Heron over Johnston City. Mount Vernon over Gallatin County. Johnston City then defeated Mount Vernon and Gallatin County. Pool number 3, Woodlawn defeated Steelville and Galatia. Marion defeated Woodlawn and Steelville and Galatia, and Steelville defeated Galatia. Now, pool number 4, Harrisburg defeated Christopher, and a Crab Orchard New Athens. It was New Athens defeating Christopher. Crab Orchard defeated Christopher, as we mentioned, and Crab Orchard defeated New Athens. Now, the semifinals, Crab Orchard defeated Carterville, Harrisburg over South Central, Marion over Heron, and Woodlawn defeated Johnston City. Now the trophy games, the final 7th place went to Johnston City defeating Carterville. 5th place went to Crab Orchard over Woodlawn, and 3rd place Heron over South Central. The championship game in that Heron Invitational and Girls High School Volleyball, the championship went to Marion. They defeated Harrisburg. College volleyball action Saturday, Lincoln College defeated Frontier in 4 sets. College softball action Saturday at Kentucky Wesleyan. Game number 1, Kentucky Wesleyan University over Frontier, 7-4. Game number 2, Frontier defeated Brescia University, 11-4. The Class S Regional Baseball Ewing Regional Championship game Saturday went to Ewing over Waltonville, 15-0. The Class M Baseball Regional. The championship game Friday afternoon saw Cesar Valier defeat Christopher, 9-7 at the Cesar Valier Regional. The Breeze Regional, Monday afternoon at 4 o'clock today. The regional championship will be Oakville taking on Nashville at 4:30. Friday afternoon, the Wayne City Regional Championship in Class M Baseball. Albion beat Fairfield 6-2. The Class L Baseball Regional Friday afternoon championship. It was Harrisburg over Massac County 18-4. The Benton Regional Friday afternoon regional championship. Benton defeated DuCoin 4-0. Now the regional softball championship game in Class S will be this afternoon at 4:30. It'll be Grayville taking on New Hope at Grayville. The baseball Class S regional championship at 4:30 this afternoon, Sisney and Iuka. The Class L baseball regional championship, 4:30 this afternoon, Flora will take on Salem. Class S softball regional championship at 5:30 this evening, St. Anne will take on Opdyke Belle Rive. And the Class M regional softball championship down at North City Omaha Henfield. It'll be NCOE taking on Hardin County. The Class L regional softball will be this afternoon in Flora. It'll be that championship game. Salem will take on Carmine White County. Also high school baseball this afternoon at 4:15. Wayne City will take on North Clay. High school volleyball action tonight at 6:15. Edwards County at El Dorado and Mount Carmel at Fairfield. Junior varsity football, 4:45 this afternoon, Edwards County will take on Vienna at Vienna. And at 6:15 tonight, Carmine White County at Fairfield. High school tennis action this afternoon at 4 o'clock. Heron will be in Fairfield. Some sad news this morning, very sad news in Major League Baseball. Miami Marlins ace Jose Fernandez was killed in a boating accident in Florida early Sunday morning. Fernandez, who was 24, was one of 3 men killed in the accident. The Coast Guard arrived on the scene around 3 a.m. Sunday morning to find a 32-foot boat upside down on a jetty off Miami Beach. Two of the victims were found dead under the vessel. One was found dead in the water. None of the deceased was wearing a life vest. Fernandez did not die from drowning. He died from trauma. Speed is suspected to be a factor in the accident because of the impact with the jetty, which is a rock formation out in the ocean. There was no evidence of alcohol or illegal drug use. The Miami Marlins announced that Sunday's game against the Atlanta Braves was canceled. Now tonight's game against the New York Mets in Miami will be played as scheduled. Golfing legend Arnold Palmer died Sunday afternoon. Palmer died of complications from heart problems. Palmer was admitted to the University of Pittsburgh Medical Center on Thursday for some cardiovascular work and weakened over the past few days. Arnold Palmer was 87. And a firing in college football. LSU has fired head coach Les Miles and offensive coordinator Cam Cameron and promoted defensive line coach Ed Oregon to interim head coach. The firing comes one day after LSU lost 18-13 at Auburn when referees overruled what had appeared to be a game-winning touchdown. Replay showed that LSU did not start the final play before the game clock hit zero. NFL football scores from Sunday. Denver, they stayed undefeated. Last year's reigning Super Bowl champions, they beat Cincinnati 29-13 or 29-17, the final score there. Seattle over San Francisco 37-18. It was the Rams. They picked up another victory over Tampa Bay 37-32. Indianapolis, a winner over San Diego 26-22. Buffalo 33, Arizona 18. Minnesota, a winner over Carolina 22-10. Green Bay beat Detroit 34-27, Baltimore 19, Jacksonville 17. In overtime, it was Miami over Cleveland 30-24. Washington over the New York Giants 29-27, Oakland over Tennessee 17-10, Kansas City beat the Jets 24-3, Philadelphia beat Pittsburgh 34-3, and Dallas beat the Bears last night in Dallas 31-17. Monday Night Football tonight, Atlanta will be in New Orleans. Major League Baseball action from yesterday. Last night up in Chicago, the Cubs won over St. Louis 3-1. The Cubs will be in Pittsburgh tonight at 6:05. Hendricks will pitch for the Cubs, and St. Louis returns home to Busch Stadium, taking on Cincinnati at 7:15 tonight. Jaime Garcia will pitch for the Cardinals. Other scores, it was Houston over the Angels 4-1, Toronto over the Yankees 4-3, the White Sox over Cleveland 3-0, Kansas City beat Detroit 12-9, the Mets, they beat Philadelphia 17-0. In 10 innings, Boston, a winner over Tampa Bay 3-2. Washington over Pittsburgh 10-7. Baltimore, a winner over Arizona 2-1. It was Cincinnati 4, Milwaukee 2. Seattle 4, Minnesota 3. Oakland 7, Texas 1. In 10 innings, the Dodgers beat Colorado, and the Dodgers win the Western Division with that victory last night over Colorado 4-3. And San Diego over San Francisco 4-3. Again, Atlanta at Miami. That game was canceled due to Jose Fernandez's death. Now, the standings real quick, the wild card standings in the National League. With that loss last night, the Cardinals, they're in the third position for the National League wild card. The Mets have a game lead over San Francisco. The Cardinals in the third position, they're a half game back of San Francisco in that National League wild card. The Cardinals still need to win, and win often. They're going to make the playoffs for this year. That's Check Sports for you on a Monday morning. I'm Mark Wells reporting. All right, it is time right now to check the area weather forecast, and this morning it's being underwritten by Home Source Warehouse, and they are located in Mount Vernon.
Monthly financial support of local Christian radio is provided by Home Source Warehouse in Mount Vernon. Located 4 miles north of Mount Vernon on Route 37, Home Source Warehouse offers a warehouse full of quality furniture and mattresses with legendary service. Open Thursday and Friday, 10 to 6, Saturday, 10 to 3. You can find them on Facebook, and their website is homesourcewarehouse.net. Their phone number is 204-5515. Home Source Warehouse, where style is affordable.
Southern Illinois weather. Well, right now we have cloudy skies, and the rain seems to have ended. That's what the forecast is calling for. The showers we had early, clearing out, ample sunshine by the sand. This afternoon we'll have a high of 75. It'll be a nice day, beautiful day, temperature-wise. Clear skies tomorrow, high 76. Clear on Wednesday, high 68. That's right. And then Thursday, chance of rain and a high of 70. Right now in the area, Flora 61, McLeansboro at 59. Carmi 59 in Wayne City right now. It is 61. 90.9 The Vine. And we welcome you back to the Vine Morning Show. Here we are on this Monday morning. Hey, you know, have you ever wondered how five popular candy bars got their names? Well, for instance, Kit Kat. That's right. First produced back in 1935 as Roundtree's Chocolate Crisp, the Kit Kat received its modern name in 1937 when it began to be marketed as the Kit Kat Chocolate Crisp. Now, frustratingly, no one can confirm where its name came from, though it is widely believed to be a reference to the famous Kit Kat Club, a 1920 jazz nightclub in London's West End, which was for a long time one of the city's most popular venues. That's right. Toblerone, now first sold in 1908. The Toblerone is a combination of milk chocolate, nougat, almonds, and honey shaped to resemble the Matterhorn Mountain. Now, the largely meaningless name makes a little more sense when you realize that it was manufactured by Swiss chocolatier Theodore Tobler, its full name, Tobler's surname, and the Italian dessert Torrone, which is a type of nougat containing honey, sugar, and nuts that forms the inspiration of the bar itself, and for the bar itself. Number three is Milky Way. Now introduced in 1923, the Milky Way was both inspired by and named after a popular malted shake of the era. Now, the intention was that the bar, the first ever filled chocolate bar, would replicate the flavors and experience of drinking the similarly named milkshake. Number four, Snickers. Now introduced in 1930, the Snickers bar was Mars's follow-up to the Milky Way. And Franklin Mars named the confection after his wife's favorite racehorse, but unfortunately, the horse passed away 2 months before the product came to market. And finally, number five, Twix. Now, for most chocolate bars, there's some clue to where the name came from, and if there isn't, you can normally work it out, but the Twix name is shrouded in mystery in much the same way as its bars are shrouded in chocolate. Now, the product originated in the UK in 1967 and earned ad campaigns in Britain and the United States emphasized the word mix, so it might be that Twix is a mixture of twin and mix or twin and sticks, referring to its pair of bars and the mixture of ingredients. So there you go. If you've ever wondered how five popular candy bars got their names, there you go, as it is the answer for those questions this morning here on the Vine Morning Show, how they got their names. And good morning, those listening on 105.5 and 90.9 The Vine, and watching our live in-studio camera this morning. If you're on our website, wvyn.org, you can see our live in-studio camera. Just click on that, and here we are, as it's myself, and over here is Lora. Good morning, Lora. How are you this morning?
Good morning. I'm just fine.
Well, it's good to see you. Welcome in. Thank you. And how did you like waking up to a cool fall? Now we can say fall morning this morning.
Yes, we certainly can. You know, I didn't get to feel it until Lucy opened the door to get out of the car, but
yeah.
But it was kind of hard waking up to the gloom. It really was.
Yeah,
kind of gloomy. And,
sure.
And but you know what? The sun, is it coming out today, Mark?
Yes, according to the forecast, a little bit later on this afternoon, we should have, and the wording is ample sunshine.
Oh, I love that. Okay. So
we'll see how ample it is coming up here in a little while.
That's great. And with cooler weather, that'll be a big blessing.
Absolutely. So. Amen. Yeah. A lot of people are looking forward this time of year.
Yeah. So. You know, it's my favorite.
Yeah.
It really is. But my mom always says it's not mine because I know what's coming
next. Well, yeah, exactly. We don't want to think about that, do we?
No. But all right. I don't know. I don't mind winter too much until, you know, February. Okay,
sure.
I'm done with this. But
right.
Anyway.
And, well, February is just a little closer to spring.
Yes,
you know, when you stop and you think about it.
Yes. So anyway, we'll take what we get.
That's right.
Yeah.
Hey, it's great to have you in on a Monday, and we have a lot to talk about.
Yes.
Right?
You know, I've got my spread of papers as usual, mm-hmm. and I'm really convicted now that Kevin's been on here with his neat stack. You know, Kevin McLean. He was so organized. I'm thinking, just how does he do it? He had every paper in order. mm-hmm. had all of his thoughts in order, and it was really nice.
I
like seeing somebody else work in this chair that
sure.
had it all together, because Laura certainly doesn't. But I wrote down a little quote I'd like to start
sure,
off with.
Sure, absolutely.
I heard a preacher say this the other day, and it's just a grand piece of advice. It says, God will give you better friends than you could ever choose for yourself.
Oh, wow. That is good.
Yeah, God,
I like that.
God will give you better friends than you could ever choose for yourself. And, you know, I think that's something that we need to pray for our kids, our grandkids, as much as we need to pray it for ourselves.
Mm-hmm.
One of the young men in our church last night wrote this post, and he was talking about how, you know, there's people in his life that is still looking at him through eyes of mistakes.
Mm-hmm.
You know, he's trying to be the best that he can be, and he says, I may not be the perfect this or the perfect weight or the perfect look, you know, but I am trying to perform in God's will. And I thought, you know what? That's good. That's great. But still, the better he's getting in his life, it seems like the more people start clawing at you.
That is so true. You do see that.
Yeah, really. And you think a lot of people are driven by jealousy and envy. And you got to look and see, why would they be so upset with you? And it's true. Our life pushes us and it moves us in different directions. And often our friends change.
Mm-hmm.
And it's something that we need to just understand. Sometimes friends are in our lives for a season, and sometimes they're lifelong friends. Mm-hmm. But that's rare.
That's very rare.
It really is.
Yeah.
You think about, do you have any childhood friends that's still real close with you, Mark?
Yeah, absolutely. Yeah, I do. I have about three.
Okay,
a small number. Mm-hmm. And, you know, I still keep in contact with quite a few friends on, you know, that go back in time. But three...
Yes.
That are close.
Okay. All right.
And I think maybe I'm not sure what the average would be.
Yeah.
But to me, I think, you know, that's pretty good because, you know, and they don't live around here. And that's another thing, too. Mm-hmm. They live in other states.
Okay.
So.
And that makes it a little bit more difficult.
A little bit more difficult.
Yes.
Yeah.
Yes.
Yeah.
But, you know, as we go through different stages in our lives, things do change. And, you know, I've been praying lately, God, choose my friends.
Mm-hmm.
Choose Blaze's friends, Lucy's friends, Tom's friends. You know, there were some friends that Tom had to cut off way back when we started dating, and I can remember there were no really spoken words, but there was two people in particular, there was a struggle
mm-hmm.
when they were around.
Right.
And I remember thinking very seriously, Tom, you were at a crossroads. We were just dating. Are you going to choose your old life, or are you going to come jump on
mm-hmm.
you know, the lane with God,
mm-hmm.
basically.
Sure, sure.
And I knew that he was going to choose God. I just knew that he was. But were there pieces and parts of that were hard for him? Absolutely.
Mm.
Because he wasn't a young guy when we met. He was 38 years old whenever we met, kind of set in his ways. And I was 28. And, you know, things were a little bit different than if we were just younger and carefree and you don't think about things as deeply.
Mm-hmm.
But he had to remove some people from his life. And I have too.
Mm-hmm.
And what I think we ultimately all need to consider every single phase of our life, God, give me the people that's going to help me stay closer to you. Give me the people in my children's lives that are going to be good for them. There's one little boy that Blaze is good friends with. And Mark, if I could look at any kid and think that kid is going to make it to the end, that child is going to make it till the roll is called up yonder.
Mm-hmm.
And I'm thinking that is the child I want to reinforce and make it real easy for them to have a relationship.
Sure.
And I think, you know, my mom's always said, if you have one or two good friends in your life, you've done well.
Yeah.
Isn't that?
I agree with that.
True.
Yeah.
True buddies. And Lucy, she has some great friends. She has a great neighbor girl, and she has a lot of people in her life. But I will say Blaze does too, but there's one that seems to be a solid fit that I could see if they lived to be 100 years old, they
mm-hmm.
would remain friends.
Sure.
I really
sure.
do. So anyhow, I think it's a big thing because bad company corrupts good character.
That's true.
That's something that's true. We always try to teach our church kids, and we always want to keep our friends lined up with what we need to be. And I just thought that was so good. I just scribbled it down and thought I'd like to pass it on.
And you know, I'm glad you said that because, you know, our realm of friends out there, some are not Christian. The majority of our, you know, your friends, my friends, Sherry's friends are Christians.
Yes,
and,
right.
You know, the thing is, being a Christian around a non-Christian is the, and we've said this many times before, that is the perfect time to where you can plant the seed.
Yes.
Into that non-Christian.
Yes.
Maybe getting them to think a little differently than you think, believe a little differently with you, how you believe.
Yes.
And because, you know, as we always say, you know, as a Christian, you're held to a higher standard.
That's true.
But you surround yourself more with Christian friends, and don't you feel the strength of God just come upon you more and more?
Yes.
And, you know, Sherry and I were talking about that not too long ago. You know, we have a lot of great Christian friends, and we keep growing that, in that network of Christian friends, which is just awesome. It's awesome for anybody that can do that.
Yes.
But one thing that we both realize, our strength in our faith in Christianity is more and more stronger the more you bond with more people who are Christians.
It's true. And I don't know if you saw my Armor of God post
I haven't seen
Okay, well, Mark, I would have thought by what you just said that you just read my mind.
No, I haven't seen
okay.
it.
Okay, all right. Well, I stole it from somebody else. But anyway, it's a picture of a group of women in a line, and they're holding hands.
Mm-hmm.
And it's like a sunset is in front of them, and all you see is this group of women standing holding hands. It shows just the back of them.
Mm-hmm.
And it was such a beautiful picture, and it talked about how women in unity, or Christians in unity,
mm-hmm.
are stronger together. We empower one another. We gain strength from one another.
Mm-hmm.
And it's so true. Whenever I'm with a group of women in a Bible study or what have you, I really, really gain strength from those people.
I know.
You know?
I know. And just like this past Saturday, I went to a men's Bible study.
Did you?
And there was like, I'm going to guess there was like 9 to 12 of us there.
That's good.
And, you know, it's like, you know, again, iron sharpens iron.
Absolutely.
And
mm-hmm.
you grow together, and
yes.
you get to not only fellowship, but you get to share the Word of God. You get to share
yes.
what it's meant to you in your life.
Yes.
And you see what it means to other men in your group, other
right.
ladies, and when you mm-hmm. ladies are together,
yes,
and when you're together with a group of ladies, you guys see that as well.
Yes, absolutely. It's faith is contagious.
Yeah, absolutely.
Yeah, I always like to say that faith is contagious. And I want to make this point too. I heard a quote from Franklin D. Roosevelt, and he said this: a man is known more by his his integrity is known more by his enemies than by his friends. Now think about this. Let's flip this up just
mm-hmm.
a little bit. Think about who your enemies are. And that can describe you as much as who your friends are.
Mm-hmm.
You think about that.
Mm-hmm.
Who hates us? You know?
Yeah. And what is the reason that they hate you?
Right. Right.
You
Absolutely.
Know.
And I thought that was a pretty powerful statement, that we can be known more by our friends by our enemies. And that was just a pretty profound statement. And so we have to look around our life, you know, treasure those friends, love those friends, and those friends can reflect us.
Sure.
They really do. But then on the total opposite end of the spectrum, we want to be constantly reminded of who our enemies are, who dislikes us, who is pot-shotting us all the time. And why is that? And it's often, like I said, driven by jealousy and hate.
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Yeah.
Often it is. So,
and you know, and when that happens, you've got to ask yourself, what's that person going through? What's their insecurity?
Yeah. Oh,
you know, what's their insecurity
good.
To make mm-hmm. them feel the way they do?
Yes, absolutely. For them to look at you and think, you know, I have this one friend. If I said her name, a lot of people would be, oh, yeah. She's beautiful. Well, she's a Christian first.
Mm-hmm.
Preacher's wife. Beautiful. Just absolutely stunning. Smart. Educated, has a great job. You look at personality out of this world, but there are many people that just cannot take her. And I'm thinking, well, that, you know, pretty well sums up. You're jealous.
Mm-hmm.
You're jealous. She's just a little too pretty. She's a little too nice. And she loves God just a little too much. And there's a lot of people that just cannot flat handle it.
You know, I had someone say one time, they're jealous because I love God. Well, you know what? They can have the same kind of jealousy that I have. Just get rid of your jealousy and love God.
Absolutely. They can have everything you've got.
Yeah, that's exactly right.
Absolutely.
Yeah, that's
so, you know, it's a tough world out there, but praying that simple prayer, I would encourage all of you to pray that simple prayer. God, would you choose my friends? Would you remove anybody from my life that is hindering me, that is tripping me up, that is causing me defeat, that is holding me back? And would you bring forth the people that would encourage me, enrich me, that would press me on and move me forward in the gifting that you want me to have and the things that you need me to do? That is a prayer we all need to pray.
Yeah, amen. Mm-hmm. Yeah, exactly. All right, we're heading into 9 o'clock. What are we going to come back and talk about?
I have something that is earth-shattering that came from the mouth of Perry Stone.
Ooh.
That is prophetic, I believe it with all of my heart, and it is a major, major announcement.
We're going to do that when we come back. All right.
All right.
Again, we welcome those listening on 105.5 and 90.9 The Vine. And if you're watching, if you're not, you can go to our website, wvyn.org, and watch us on our live in-studio camera this morning, as it is Mark and Laura. And we're going to come back in the 9 o'clock hour as the Vine Morning Show on this Monday morning. It continues right here at Real Life Radio.
This is your home for best Christian music.
WVYN, Blueford, Wayne City, Fairfield, Mount Vernon.
And now on translator, W288CO Centralia, broadcasting at 105.5.
A service of Real Life Radio Foundation.
The best Christian music, 90.9.
My own little world, it hardly ever rains. I've never gone hungry, always felt safe. I got some money in my pocket, shoes on my feet. In my own little world, population, me. I try to stay awake during Sunday morning church. I throw a 20 in the plate, but I never give till it hurts. And I turn off the news when I don't like what I see. Yeah, it's easy to do when it's population, me. What if there's a bigger picture? What if I'm missing out? At a red light, looked out my window. I saw cardboard signs that held this homeless widow. And just above that sign was the face of a human. I thought to myself, God, what have I been doing? So I rolled down the window and I looked her in the eye. Oh, how many times have I just passed her by? Drove on through.
an open doors. Put your light in my eyes and let me see that my own little world is not about me. What if there's a bigger picture? What if I'm missing out? What if there's a greater purpose that I could be living right now? I don't wanna miss what matters. I wanna be reaching out. Show me the greater purpose so I can start living right now. Outside my own little world. Ooh, my own little world. Yeah, yeah. My own little world.
Ooh. Music and ministry. As always, uplifting and encouraging. Local Christian Radio 105.5 and 90.9 The Vine, My Own Little World. That is Matthew West. It is time right now for Uncommon Moments with Tony Dungy and his wife Lauren Dungy. And this morning, it's being underwritten by Fairfield National Bank.
As a financial advisor, John Reynolds is well-versed in the best practices of financial planning. But as a local, raised in Wayne County, he's more than experienced with the unique challenges you face every day. After growing up here, he's now returned, investing back into the community that contributed to his success, passionate and committed to helping you with yours. FNB Asset Management. We're here to help.
What does it take to live an uncommon life? Here's former Super Bowl winning coach Tony Dungy with today's Uncommon Moment.
Perhaps the most notable characteristic of mentoring leadership that differentiates it from other leadership styles is what I call a multiplication mindset. Unfortunately, too many leaders operate from a paradigm that asks, how will this better me or better my organization? How will this improve the bottom line? How will this improve my chances for a bonus or a promotion? The mentor leader, by contrast, looks at how he or she can benefit others, which ultimately benefits the individual and the organization. Mentor leaders are committed to building value into the lives of other people. Think about it. How much better would things be if you were building leaders who were building leaders who were building leaders? That's what I call leader multiplication, and it reaps great rewards.
Tony Dungy. Discover more at CoachDungy.com.
Here's what's happening at the
The next Vine concert is just around the corner on Thursday, September 29th, as we welcome the Sidewalk Prophets to Little Chapel Church in Harrisburg. VIP tickets and reserve seat tickets are still available for the Prodigal Tour featuring the Sidewalk Prophets on Thursday, September 29th at Little Chapel Church in Harrisburg. Get your tickets at the church or at Hope in a Future Christian Bookstore in Fairfield, Daystar in Mount Vernon, or print them off and purchase online through our website.
The best Christian music, 90.9 The Vine.
Up a pen and a page, and I started writing just what I'd say if we were face to face. I tell you just what you mean to me, tell you these simple truths. Be strong in the Lord, never give up hope. You're gonna do great things, I already know. God's got his hand on you, so don't live life in fear. Forgive and forget, but don't forget why you're here. Take your time and pray. These are the words I would say. You were hurting, and I felt your pain in my heart. I want to tell you that I keep on praying. Love will find you where you are. I know.
simple truths. Be strong in the Lord and never give up hope. You're gonna do great things, I already know. God's got his hand on you, so don't live life in fear. Forgive and forget, but don't forget why you're here. Take your time and pray. These are the words I would say. From one simple life to another,
I would say. That is the Sidewalk Prophets here at Real Life Radio 105.5 and 90.9 The Vine. Again, if you don't have your tickets for this Thursday, it's not too late to get them. 7 o'clock, the Prodigal Tour featuring the Sidewalk Prophets at Little Chapel Church in Harrisburg. Go to our website, wvyn.org. You can print off tickets right there off our website. Get them at Daystar in Mount Vernon or Hope in a Future Christian Bookstore in Fairfield. Now, VIP tickets are available. And you can click on a special red box on our website at wvyn.org and sit in the first six rows and enjoy a Q&A session with the Sidewalk Prophets again this Thursday at 7 o'clock. It's all happening at Little Chapel Church in Harrisburg. Right now it's time for Family Minute with Mark Merrill. We're going to come back with Laura in just a moment, so stay tuned. And Family Minute being underwritten by the Tin Shed. They're located in Wayne City. 105.5 and 90.9 The Vine is thankful for the underwriting support of the Tin Shed in Wayne City. They are your source for primitive, country, and home decor in a wide selection to meet your decorating needs. The Tin Shed is located at 701 West Robinson in Wayne City, and their phone number is 895-2155.
Are you equipped to protect your child from stress? I'm Mark Merrill with today's Family Minute. A recent study from the University of Florida revealed that major childhood stresses like divorce, exposure to substance abuse, and economic hardship have an almost immediate negative impact on a child's health. So, what can you do? First, protect your child from the stress of divorce. Sometimes divorce is beyond the control of a spouse. However, there are times when couples all too quickly buy into the myth that we fight a lot, so the children will be better off if we just split up. Arguing isn't ideal, but divorce can be worse. Second, protect your child from the impact of substance abuse. You can hide that abuse from some, but not from your kids. So get help before it hurts. Remember, your family first.
For more resources on today's topic, go to markmerrill.com. The Family Minute with Mark Merrill, helping families love well.
And we welcome you back. Thanks for listening to local Christian radio for you and your family. If you're on 105.5, the Centralia area, or anywhere else in Southern Illinois on 90.9 The Vine. And if you're on our website right now at wvyn.org, we're live. Our in-studio camera is on, and you can see Laura and myself right now as what we're talking about on the radio is on camera this morning. Mm-hmm. And we welcome you. Thanks for tuning in. As Laura's with us this morning, you know, you're one of your favorite people. He's one of my favorite people.
Yes.
And anytime Perry Stone speaks, you need to listen.
Yes, you do.
You do.
You really do. And my mom, she says sometimes when I listen to him, he scares me a little bit. And I get it because
sure.
He really has some prophetic words.
Right.
And Perry, if you're not familiar with him, Perry Stone is really into the prophetic things and the things to come. Mm-hmm. all of these things that are lining up, he is really one to understand it.
Yes.
Like the book of Daniel and Revelation and different things. And he knows about the kingdoms to come and the rulers and you know, what it's going to come down to at the very last, the different powers. And he can explain it all just absolutely beautiful. Well, he said something that I was out taking a walk the other day listening to one of his messages, and I nearly stopped whenever I was taking my walk. He says, "Not in 40 years of preaching have I ever said anything like this." He said, "I know I'm going to get lots of rebuttal on emails," and he said, "lots of negative comments are going to be made, but I'm going to say this anyway." He says, "God has revealed to me the Antichrist is on the planet."
Well, you know, a lot of people speculated he's here already.
Yes,
you
many
know, a
people
lot,
have.
Lot, yeah, you're right. Mm-hmm. And a lot of people, not only Perry Stone, but, you know, some other biblical scholars out there that, mm-hmm. you know, they have always wondered if yes. he's not here.
Yes.
Already.
Yes, right. Now, he said, "God did not reveal to me whether it was a baby or a man." He says, "I don't know that, but he's here."
Mm.
Woo, Mark. Now that puts things, you know, now, if you don't know Perry Stone, that may not mean much to you. But all of us that knows Perry Stone, he is a straight shooter, isn't
exactly.
he, Mark?
Exactly. He sure is. And he's someone to pay attention to.
He's someone to pay attention to. He really is anointed, wouldn't you say?
Yes, yes. Very anointed.
Very, extremely anointed. And he is one of God's chosen. Mm-hmm. No doubt.
No doubt. No mm-mm. doubt about it.
No doubt. He says he's got now over 100,000 hours of study. He studies all day long. He says, "You can ask any of my staff." He said, I study all day long. He's had so many profound things happen to him that makes you know that he is what he is. Here's an example. It was maybe months, a few years ago. I'm not really sure. Well, no, I know it had to be a few years ago because of his ministry. But he said that his son was stricken with an illness.
Mm-hmm.
And he said, "I knew that I knew that I knew it was an attack of the enemy." And he says, "I am sitting in the hospital room and I am looking at my son laid out on that bed. And as I am praying," he says, "I speak to the devil and I tell the devil, you are going to pay for this. I am going to make sure that you're going to pay for this." And whoo, I love that. I love that. You know, so many of us think that we just need to, you know, just kind of cower down to Satan or be afraid of him or shudder at his presence. No, 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 no. He needs to shudder at our presence because we have the one true living God, Jesus Christ, and his blood flowing through us. He needs to be afraid of us. But he said that shortly after this, I'm not getting the story exactly right, that he had a vision or a dream that he would be the father of many. The father of many. And he didn't really know what that meant exactly. He didn't quite understand it. But he said that very soon after that, he went to this prayer meeting unannounced, and there was a speaker up there, and they pointed Perry out to the back. And he said, "Come up here." And he says, "I want you to know that you are going to have a ministry of youth." He said, "A ministry of many. You are going to be the father of many." And he says, "I wasn't sure what that meant, but he knew it was a confirmation." And he said, "It was amazing how the doors opened. And now they have hundreds and hundreds. Sometimes," he says, "they have 3,000 at their youth groups." And you know what they call Perry Stone? Papa Perry.
Mm.
Papa Perry.
Mm-hmm.
And it's like from that moment, he warned the devil, "I'm going to get you for this. I am going to take this, what you meant for harm, and God's going to turn it into good." And his son did recover.
Mm.
But he went on that it was prophesied over him that from that point on, he would be the father of many. And it's like Satan was trying to take his teenager's life, his youth's life, but Perry took it, and with God, and they took off running to where he is the father of many. Mm-hmm. And there are so many wonderful stories that if you listen to Perry, that only God could have orchestrated these things, only he could have put them in his path and caused these directions, but the man is for real.
Mm-hmm.
He's legit.
Yeah, yeah.
He really is. And I believe he speaks to Perry, and Perry has declared that the Antichrist is here.
He is here. Wow. Wow.
Now, that puts things down to a certain amount of time, because how long can a person live on this earth? Mm-hmm. You know, I mean, 70 years if they have the strength, maybe 80. I mean, we know about what the proper time is. And like you said, I don't know how old this person is, but they're here. Mm. So that's something to chew on, something to think on, something to consider on. For all these people that still want to say, oh, the rapture is way, you know, in the future, it's way off, and everybody's been saying this for so long, so long, so long. It's different now. It's different now, and this is just another piece to the puzzle, affirming and confirming where we're at on the scale of time.
Yeah, you just look at the news today, what things are happening, and how rapidly change is taking place in our country today, around the world.
You are right.
And, you know, and you, if you read it, and you read scriptures in the Bible that talk about what will take place before the return of Christ, look what's going on.
Absolutely.
It's unfolding more and more rapidly, faster than we can really blink our eyes.
Oh, really? And you know, I had my mom at the chiropractor the other day. I don't remember if I told this story or not, but they have a television on, and I'm sitting there, and I'm looking, and like North Carolina, breaking news. And Mark, I was just like, I mean, it didn't even really mean that much. Breaking news? Oh, well, it's breaking news every day. They're going to have to get a new term for breaking news, because Lora Greathouse, I'm ashamed to say, I'm almost desensitized to the words breaking news because it just happens so much now.
Yeah.
It's almost like it doesn't mean what it used to mean, because it's normalcy for us now. It's a normal thing for us to see. You know, before breaking news, well, you just drop your dishes. Mm-hmm. You drop your laundry. You drop your work. You would turn around and you would just stop in your living room right where you were at to see what in the world happened.
Mm-hmm.
And now it's just happening so much, you just don't even think about it. And I'm sorry for those people that had breaking news in North Carolina. I'm not trying to minimize that.
Sure,
terribly sorry for their pain, but it's just such a natural thing anymore.
So much hatred in the world today.
Mm-hmm.
And you look how it's affecting people, affecting their lives. And we're in an area right now where we're not close to it at this point, but when is it going to strike our area? You know, when is it going to strike? You look at these small communities in North Carolina that thought it will never happen here, and it's right out their back door.
Right.
And it could turn here and happen.
It could.
I mean, you know, it's just a part of the times we're living in today.
Yes.
And it's nothing to overlook. No. We have to pay attention. And again, we have to be watchful.
We do.
That's what we have to be watchful.
We do. And you know, when I was in the chiropractor's office, there was a lady that came in, and she saw this North Carolina stuff, and she said that there was a man up on the square with a big orange cardboard and had something on there, you know, protesting. And I thought, wow, you know, little pieces of things are in every direction.
Sure.
They sure are. But you know, once again, we've just got to be that bright light that just keeps getting brighter, and we don't be quiet. We've got to be moving. We've got to be shaking for God. We've got to pray for our nation. Have this little card, pray for America.
Yeah.
And it's talking about on the back, we need to repent. First and foremost, whenever we're praying for the crisis in the world, the call is heavy on Americans. We know that we're an important piece, at least at the moment, of the world's problems. And repentance is number one, seek the Lord. Number three, unity. We spoke about unity earlier.
Right.
How strong we feel when we're with a group of Christians. And then number four, praying protection and blessings. And I pray often, Lord, help us to miss these things which are to come.
Mm-hmm.
I pray that a lot, and I know that it's just zooming around, and as you can see the picture that's on the front of this little card that's calling our nation to pray. I mean, it shows all these big, you know, the St. Louis Arch and these bridges and different pieces all across America, and reminding us of our nation.
Well, you know, that's look what Franklin Graham is doing.
Yes.
He's traveling all over the country.
Yes.
And
yes,
if you follow any of the things that Franklin Graham's been doing, pray for America. And
yes,
I had an opportunity, a bunch of us from our church went to the state capitol here a few months back. And it was packed in Springfield. And if you follow his where he's going and praying, it's packed. Everywhere you go, you can see thousands and thousands and thousands of people.
Right.
So it goes to show you one thing. America knows we're in trouble.
Yes, right.
We know as a Christian nation, our country is in trouble.
Yes.
And if we don't pray, and if we don't lift our prayers up to God, it's not going to get any better.
Yes, that's exactly right. And, you know, yes, we just have a few short weeks to really put those prayers in motion. And you know, we got one way that's going to give the Christians some breathing room and respect the Christians. And that assures us that they're not going to be a hated group of people.
Mm-hmm.
And then we have another direction that's telling us that we need to get away from our deep-seated religious beliefs so abortion can move forward.
Mm-hmm.
So we have two choices. And, you know, we talked, you know, a week or two ago about if it's lost, if our election is lost, it's very likely it's from blinded Christians.
Sure. You know, and Franklin Graham, when he was giving these speeches, you know, he's in his, and I'll never forget this. He says, our nation is in trouble. We have turned our backs against God.
Mm-hmm.
And he was very emphatic about what he stated.
Yes.
And that jumps out at you.
Yes, it does. It
does. And we are.
We are.
We are in trouble
as a
nation.
Yeah, and he's a great guy. And lift Franklin up. He's working really hard.
Mm-hmm.
I mean,
mm-hmm.
and they hate him. He can't even go in some of the White House? Is he got kicked out from some?
There's
big place.
Something, yeah. There's somewhere where you know they've kind of said, well, you know, we just assume you're not welcome here. I can't remember where that's at, but in a nice way, not so nice way, they tell him that.
Yes, right. And I think good for you, Franklin, that there's one of those places that they've just totally removed you from. Good for you, because you stood and you were strong and you said the right things.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, so. And he stood his ground. That's right.
Mm-hmm.
All right, we're going to come back in a moment. What else we got to talk
okay,
about
Okay, well,
today,
let's
Lora?
Talk a little bit about dreams.
Dreams.
Yes.
All right.
Yes,
yeah, everyone has a dream. Yeah, we're going to do that when we come back with Lora here in just a little while. All right, more to come. Zealand Worship, Your Love is Wild. It's coming up next right here at the bottom.
So, you're done with it. You've had enough. It's too hard. Too much to overcome. You want to give up. But he doesn't.
Never stop.
Keep going on 105.5 and 90.9 The Vine.
Your mercy
Your Love is Wild. That is Zealand Worship from Real Life Radio 105.5 and 90.9 The Vine. We're going to come back with Laura in just a little bit. We're going to hear from about a mile in a moment, but right now it's time for Hope Out Loud from the Barrick family. And it's underwritten this morning by Monroe County and McLeansboro. Real Life Radio Foundation is blessed by the generosity of Monroe Accounting and McLeansboro. They specialize in a full line of accounting services for businesses, individuals, and farms, including tax preparation, payroll preparation, quarterly sales taxes, and more. Their office is located at 102 East Market Street in downtown McLeansboro, with experience and knowledge to serve your needs. Their phone number is 643-3993. Monroe Accounting in McLeansboro, a proud supporter of 90.9 and 105.5 The Vine.
Today on Hope Out Loud, Josh and Linda Barrick.
Mom, I love having a big family.
Well, I would hardly call our family of four big.
Oh, I don't mean just the four of us. I mean the family of God. Romans 8:15 says, when we receive God's Spirit, we're adopted as His kids. Because of what Jesus did on the cross, I can call every Christian my brother or sister, which means I have a pretty enormous family.
That's true. And our Father is the King of the universe, so that also makes us royalty. Dear Jesus, thank you for bringing us into your family. Help my friend listening right now to remember their identity as your child.
Amen. Discover true joy in Linda's new Bible study in Philippians called Total Bliss. Learn more at hopeoutloud.com.
Real Life Radio, 90.9 The Vine.
My heart's beating inside my chest. My lungs breathing the oxygen. But I need something more than this to keep me alive. I'm so sick of wasting time, living life like I'm half alive. I'm done believing these evil lies that tell me hopes and dreams have died. I can feel it in the air tonight, way up above these city lights. There's a higher calling on all our lives. Let's live to love, not just survive.
Wake up, what are we waiting for? We know that we were made for more. We're not living just cause we were born. There's no doubt about it. We were born to live. Born to live.
There it goes like a lightning flash. Seconds pass and don't come back. Make every moment a memory to last. Last short, it moves too fast. Each breath is a gift from above. New mercies for me to receive. I become speechless. See the sun coming up. Fall to my knees. Surrender to love.
Wake up, what are we waiting for? We know that we were made for more. We're not living just cause we were born. There's no doubt about it. We were born.
Oxygen, but I know I am more than this.
What's the point if we just survive? Let's come alive.
Music and ministry that helps you connect with God. It is local Christian radio 105.5 and 90.9 The Vine. That's from the group About a Mile and their song called Born to Live. It is 9:36. We welcome you back to The Vine Morning Show. Here we are on a beautiful Monday morning. I'm Mark and Laura with me this morning, and you're listening on 105.5, 90.9 The Vine, or possibly tuned in to our website, wvyn.org, and as we are on our live in-studio camera this morning, we welcome you. Thanks for watching and listening as we're with Laura, and a lot of great topics we've been talking about this morning. Now we're gonna talk about, we all have dreams, don't
yes,
we, Laura?
Yes, yes, yes. And, you know, I have been very interested in the dreams that I dream and that other people dream for a while now. And I even spoke to you and asked your opinion off air about what would you think if I taught a session on dreams to a group of ladies that I know, and you seem to think it'd be a good idea.
I think so.
Anyhow, I've been very interested in biblical meaning of dreams, and John Paul Jackson is my favorite. Now, Perry Stone, he does have a book about interpreting your dreams.
I thought he did.
Yes.
I was going to ask you if he had a book on that.
Yes, yes. And, you know, he was speaking about, is the fourth watch of the night, does that begin at 3? Does that sound right, Mark?
I think that's correct.
All right. Yes. And he said that many times the Lord will begin to speak to you in those wee hours after 3 o'clock in the morning. And he will, you know, give you all the reasons why to back it up. But, you know, you think about it, when is a very peaceful time? And now, not you, because poor thing, you have to work all night long.
Up all night, but you know, I think we do go into that experience.
Yes.
You know, when we get into that realm, or however that's
yes,
called.
Yes, yeah. right. And so Perry, you know, it really piqued my interest a few weeks ago when I heard him talking about this, and he said often the Lord will lay things on his heart in that period of time, and sometimes you're awakened at that period of time, and you just can't get things off your mind. Pastor Steve, a wonderful example that just came to my mind. Last week, I believe it was, he had a sermon, and normally everything's up on the board, you know, that he wants to talk to. Well, nothing was. He says, let me tell you why. He says, God woke me up at 3 o'clock this morning, and it was like a download. And he says, got all fresh new sermon. So I have, you know, nothing documented, and nothing's up there, no verses or, you know, are tagged for you guys to see up on the screen today. And that is a perfect example that God can move in a very still part of the night whenever we're very, very relaxed. And, you know, I've told you before that even right before I wake up, just boom, something comes to me. Just right before I wake up, strange things. And words, Rapha Jehovah. Jehovah Rapha, maybe I got that back. That came to me one day. That's healer. Our Jesus as healer, Rapha, healer. And that just came out of nowhere. I wasn't dreaming anything about it.
Sure.
And it just, boom, it was in my mind. Let me tell you something I didn't tell you. I only told one other person this. You all, if you've been listening for the past couple weeks, know that my family and friends of I have had the great opportunity of meeting a man in India. And he has one mutual Facebook friend of mine, and he requested my friendship, and I checked him out, and it's just absolutely crazy how this story has unfolded. But he has been placed into our lives, and the man had nothing, had a hut, 16 orphan kids, 2 widows, and his own little family. And we felt it strongly in our heart to help him. We scraped together $238 and sent it to him, and he was just overwhelmed. He said, I have no words, only tears. And did you know that 3 hours after we sent that, his house burned down? And they was able to save, you know, some things, clothes and different things. It was able to save a little bit, lost all their chickens, lost the house and everything. But, you know, some crazy things have happened in my dream before. I don't know if it was a week. I don't know if it was a few days. But one of those things happened to me right before I woke up. I saw a man that could very easily have been of Indian descent. And he looked kind of just kind of sad and scared and distraught. I don't know, it looked like just a picture, for lack of better words, a mugshot, but not a mugshot, just a one little snapshot of some man that looked really like he had gone through something really bad. And then a few days later, Ratna calls me, and I could tell as soon as he turned the phone on his face, because we FaceTime, I'm like, something's wrong. And I had only known him for a few weeks, but I knew him well enough to know something's really wrong. And you could tell that he'd been crying. His hair was messed up. His face kind of, you could just see it was really bad. He said at 1:30 in the morning, our home burnt to the ground, but everyone's okay. Everyone's fine. And so anyhow, my brother is like, I'm going to Israel in a few weeks. Maybe I'll just drop in on Ratna. And I'm like, oh my goodness, this is so amazing. But he says, I need to know, should I go there? Should we invest, you know, our energy and our finances and calling on others to get him here? He says, I don't know. And Ratna's saying the same thing. We would love for Rodney to come, but I really am longing to come to America. And so anyhow, I was telling him a few weeks ago, he brought up, he says, I've been fasting and I've been praying about whether I should come, and my wife is too. And I said, it's funny you should mention fasting, because I just had a dream a couple days ago that I was at our church. There was this buffet line. I went up to fill up my plate, and there was these three ladies, and one of them leaned into me and said, we should fast from 4:30 on Saturday to 4:30 on Sunday. And I did. In real life, I did. I just felt very led to, and I felt led to on Ratna's behalf for so many different reasons. And so then after I did the fast, he's bringing up to me about fasting the next day. Mm-hmm. And I'm like, that's funny you should say that. Let me tell you about my dream. And so I did. And I said, and I did the fast, and I did pray for you, as I felt very strong to pray for you. Well, this was many days have passed. I never told him the second part of my dream, but I did last night. I don't even know why. I said, Ratna, you remember that dream that I told you about fasting? And he said, yes. And I said, I had a second part to that dream that I never shared with you. And I said, and the reason why is because sometimes it takes you a while to figure a dream out.
I agree with that.
And yeah. I had to think about this. What did this really mean? So the second part to that dream, I went into the sanctuary, and there was a bunch of kids up on the stage doing a song or something. And the only people that were out in the crowd was Blaze and Lucy and me and Tom. But there was one person sitting in front of us, and it was a young man with dark hair that was going to preach. And I was so proud of this person, and I patted him on the back. And I remember distinctly that he had a dark blue suit on.
Mm.
So anyway, I told Ratna this story last night, and all of a sudden, he just says, Lora, Lora, that is so amazing. He said, my friend, whenever Bindu and I got married, he gave us money. And he said, and I bought something very special with it for my wedding. And his wife went and got it. And it was the suit.
The blue suit.
It was a blue suit. He says, it's the only suit I have. And I was surprised he even had one suit. But he said, I own a blue suit, and she went and got it and showed it to me, and it was just the most profound thing in the world to me. He is longing to get here. He is longing to preach and to tell his story to Americans. Now, does that dream mean anything? Is it from God? I don't know, yeah. But I'd like to think so.
Sure.
You know?
Sure.
I'd like to think so. I really do believe that God speaks to us in dreams, that he gives us dreams, he gives us visions. And why do I believe that? Because it's in the Bible. Because that's God, how God worked throughout the Bible, was giving people word pictures, giving them dreams, giving them visions. And when we see things, Mark, lit up in a dream, lit up in a vision, it becomes powerful.
Mm-hmm.
Don't you think
mm-hmm.
so?
Mm-hmm.
I mean, yeah. I really think it becomes a powerful, and it moves you. It's like it sets your body at a more extreme pace whenever you've had a dream. And you know, if you've never had the dream, you may not understand this, but if you've had a dream and you couldn't get out of your head, those are the ones that I pay attention to, Mark, the ones that just keep coming back.
And they stick in your brain.
They stick
in your mind.
In your brain, yes. And sometimes they take days to figure out, weeks to figure out. I've even had dreams where it's taken me months to figure out this dream before you can even start to pull it together. But this is what I want to do. Mm-hmm. I want to help other people in my own little tiny way, because I'm just a student, learn that God can speak to you through these dreams. We spend a third of our life asleep, and God could be pouring things into us that He wants us to know, that directions that He wants us to move in, that He wants us to go. And a place to begin is writing these things down. Mm-hmm. If you have a dream, I've been keeping a notepad and a pen next to my bed, and I've been writing down these dreams with the dates and the times, and it's so amazing to watch this. And you know, even Ratna on the other end, he told me before I even mentioned this dream to him, he said, I had a dream that we were in your red car and you were driving me around to stages that I have never seen. Mm. Yes. And he says, I am in high hopes that God is speaking to me, that He is wanting me to come to America. But I don't know. I know it's a little freaky to people. Woo, dreams. You really think God speaks to you in dreams? Yeah. I do.
I do. I believe that.
Call me crazy. I do. And with what little bit that I've learned, I know that it's not so much the storyline as it is symbols in the dream, as it is pieces, colors, mm-hmm. numbers. Mm-hmm. I've had numbers being spoken to me in dreams, 465. Never will forget that. I looked that up in Hebrew numerology and got to reading about, you know, it speaking about God and maybe I can't even remember what it was, but it spoke to me so deeply at the time. But numbers, paying attention if you're dreaming about numbers, pay attention to who's. I've been dreaming a lot about babies. Mm-hmm. A dark-headed guy, kind of looked like Joel Osteen, handed me a baby that looked just like him. And you know, Mark, after giving that great consideration, I really believe that was Ratna in my dream. And a baby can signify a new ministry, mm-hmm. a new beginning. If you dream that you're expecting, if you dream about a baby, it's not necessarily about a baby or that you're going to have a baby. It could be God is birthing something new in your life, and He wants you to take notice. He wants you to pay attention. He wants you to understand that. Often if you're dreaming about cars in your dreams, you are dreaming about a ministry. Your vehicle is often a ministry, your ministry in your dream. I had a dream that my buddy and I were in a bus the other day, and often a bus can signify a large ministry. And she's wanting to do and is doing some of the same similar things that I am doing. And so anyway, dark clouds. Okay, I'm going to shut up after this. I'm really getting wound up now, Mark. I'm getting my getting my ideas
getting
on here.
Getting your groove going.
I had a dream that I was on this like little platform of some sort, and this lady took me up to this cloud. It was this big round cloud, and I just grabbed a chunk of this cloud. It was exhilarating, and when you dream about clouds, that has meaning. And I just want everybody to know about this, because you're going to see your dreams differently. You're going to be more aware of your dreams, and God is going to be able to speak to you more through these dreams. First, if you believe. Second, if you have a tiny little bit of understanding. And you know what? It's not weird, because it's in the Bible. Mm-hmm. I'll shut up now.
It's in the Bible. It is. We'll come back here in a moment and wrap it up with Laura here on the Vine Morning Show. More to come. And we encourage you to stay tuned. And her program, Keeping Watch, is coming up right here at the Vine.
Real Life Radio is thankful for the financial partnership we have with Greenwald & Sons Construction in Wayne City and in Mount Vernon. They specialize in residential and commercial construction and remodeling. They have a long list of satisfied customers spanning over 38 years. Whether it's a church addition, business expansion, or new home construction, Greenwald & Sons Construction of Wayne City and Mount Vernon are experts that you can depend on. Their phone number is 895-2044. And we thank them for their support of local Christian radio.
Christian music and programming on The Vine is made possible by Wes Rogers Tire and Auto Service in Mount Vernon. Located at 1321 South 10th Street in Mount Vernon, Wes Rogers Tire and Auto Service offers customer service the way it should be and is 100% locally owned and operated. With ASE certified mechanics, Wes Rogers Tire and Auto Service is committed to your complete auto care satisfaction. Their phone number is 315-6497. And we are thankful for their support.
Hi, this is Ashley DeVoy with the Fairfield Banking Company. We've been strongly rooted in this area since 1892. Our foundation is strong, and we offer a unique checking account for customers 50 and older. It's called the 1892 Founders Club Checking, and it puts your money to work with interest paid on balances of $1,000 or more. You've worked hard to build a strong financial foundation for yourself, and now it's time to reap the rewards, including free checks and paper statements. Learn more about the 1892 Founders Club Checking account available at the Fairfield Banking Company, 915 Commerce Drive, member FDIC and Equal Housing Lender.
Real Life Radio is grateful for the underwriting support of Taylor Flooring in Mount Vernon. Located at 328 Main Street in Mount Vernon, Taylor Flooring specializes in the sales, service, and installation of top brands such as Mohawk, Southwind, and LW Mountain. 100% locally owned and operated by Mark and Sherry Taylor, Taylor Flooring in Mount Vernon has your flooring needs covered. Their phone number is 315-6004.
He who has an ear to hear, let him hear what the Spirit says to the churches. This is Keeping Watch with Lora Greathouse.
Remember in the Bible when the Israelites said, maybe we should just go back. How many of you are thinking of just going back? Back to an old job, situation, way of life. Why do we want to go back? Why does it even cross our minds to go back to something we once lived and didn't work? We often go back out of sheer fear. Fear is one of the mightiest tools the enemy torments us with. And often when we are making a move forward, sticking our necks out to speak for something more, fear chases us back, puts us in our places. Well, out there, our enemies are bold. Terror around the world is spreading like a disease. They are ready to die for their cause, while many Christians are shrinking back, drawing in, becoming very cautious, afraid to speak, teach, or preach because they have been struck with fear. Jonathan Cahn said recently, as our enemies get bolder, so should we. As Satan's demons get more powerful, so should we. And he's right. If these terrorists can stand so firm for a lie, how much stronger should we be able to stand for the truth? The end of the end is near. Don't be silenced by fear.
This has been Keeping Watch with Lora Greathouse, heard twice daily on 105.5 and 90.9 The Vine.
Well, Lora, again, time has come and gone so fast this morning. But a lot of good things we've talked about this morning, and I think, you know, it's the things that God laid on your heart that need to be brought out.
Well, I hope so. And like I told you off air, it took me a little while to get warmed up today. I don't know if I'm tired or what, but
getting to it. Oh, no. And you know, I like when you get wound up because I know that's where God is leading you to.
Well,
and, you know, and we were talking about this off the air, and I fully believe this, that God gives discernment to certain people.
Yes.
I really believe that.
Yes.
I know there's
yes.
a special person in my life that has mm-hmm. a gift that I believe is a gift of discernment from the Lord.
Yes, from what you've told me,
yes.
I agree.
Yes, and, mm-hmm. and I truly believe that.
Yes.
And those people are equipped with that gift for a reason.
Yes.
Not to make predictions by no,
no
means.
Heavens,
not,
no.
No means whatsoever. But I think God, He chooses people with these gifts for a reason.
Yes, yes. And you know, and I'll just say this real quick little story. John Paul Jackson has been mm-hmm. one of my major reasons why I am getting so interested in dreams and visions. And the story with him was he had this corporate job, 30-some years old, thought he was really something. He come from a long line of pastors, and he knew that he needed to get closer to God. And he says, you know, I'm just going to start listening to a little bit of Christian radio.
Mm-hmm.
And so he puts it on, and here's how this story happened. There was this lady in Jerusalem, an old lady, and I think I've told this story before, and she had a dream that she was supposed to go to America, to a radio station in Dallas. She was given everything, but she had no money, she had no plane reservations, nothing. She just felt the leading to go to this airport. She goes there. She's just sitting there feeling like a fool, thinking, what am I doing here? I don't have a plane reservation, a ticket. I don't have any money, nothing. This man walks up to her and said, are you going to America? And she said, yes. And he says, are you going to Dallas? And she said, yes. And he says, do you have the money? Just like he was getting more disgusted at the moment. She said, no. And he throws the money at her and says, here. And walks off. So he was led to give this money to her. Didn't want to. Didn't do it with a happy heart. She gets on this plane, got a same day flight, goes straight into Dallas, walks into this radio station. The people that's normally there doing the show had to be off for 2 weeks. She sits up there and she says, I am here. And she told him the profound story that got her here. And she says, God told me that I am to find the young man that he has anointed and ordained to interpret dreams and visions. And she says, I need to be here for 3 days until we find him. Mm-hmm. And so John Paul Jackson on the other end, thinking he's got the world by the tail, but he needs to get a little closer to God because his family really wanted him to be a pastor. He didn't want to be a pastor. He starts listening to this and listening to the story. There's a young man out there. Please call in. One after the other, these people would call in. She goes, that's great. Maybe you have the gift of dreams and interpreting dreams, but you're not the man. Just over and over. He says, by the second day, he was really listening to this. He tuned in again, really listened to this, and he started to get emotionally attached and where he was praying for this young man. And he says, by the third day, tears were overwhelming him. He said, I had to shut my door because I think my secretary thought I was having a nervous breakdown. And he said, it started coming upon me to call. I'm not calling. He started fighting with the Lord. That's insane. I don't want to do this. I love my job. This is crazy. So anyway, the very last caller, he says, Lord, I'm going to call. Don't want to call. Don't want this job. He says, but so I'm going to make this real hard for you. He says, I want to bypass the person that answers the phone. I want to be live. And he calls in. They took his phone. When he says, as soon as he heard them say, you're on live, he about hit the ground. But he told this lady, he says, when I'm close to God, he says, I get dreams from God and they come to pass. And he says, when I'm not close to God, I don't have the dreams. And she said, young man, the man that I came here to find is you. And there was a book written about it. And, you know, whenever you hear the stories of John Paul Jackson, whenever you hear these things that they say, you know that you know God, and I'm not saying me, but God has given certain people special dreams, and he's given certain people an ability to interpret these dreams. And now that John Paul Jackson and other people like Perry Stone have been given the gift to teach other people, here's how you can interpret these dreams. Here's how you can do it. There is something to this, people. And I know it's very strange. It's very weird. It's very odd. And some of you may dismiss it and say, that cannot happen. It cannot be. Give it another look. That's what I want to encourage people. I'm going to teach this very, very soon. Give it another thought.
Good stuff.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
Thanks for coming in, Laura.
Thank you, buddy.
All right. You're welcome. Hey, that's going to do it for the Vine Morning Show. Always remember to read Scripture daily and stay focused on God and His Word. Jenny Lee is coming up next. She'll have the overflow for you. That's coming up next right here at The Vine. Have a great day, everyone.
This is your home for best Christian music.
WVYN, Blueford, Wayne City, Fairfield, Mount Vernon.
And now on Translator, W288CO Centralia, broadcasting at 105.5.
A service of Real Life Radio Foundation.
The best Christian music, 90.9, The Vine.
I tend to be busier than I should be, and I tend to think the time.